Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning, taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adlai Aiste, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, The Source of Joy. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Psalm chapter 1, verse 2. It says, But whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on his law day and night. Children, happy people find their joys in deep things of God. He is the source of joy and reservoir of power. That is why happy people find their joy in the Eternal's law. It would be well for every boy and girl, yes, every adult too, to cry out with King David, Open my eyes that I may see wonderful things in your law. Psalm 119, verse 18. The law is the transcript of his character. First, God is love. The law is the law of love. Second, God is perfect. The law is perfect. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. Psalm 19, verse 7. Third, God is just. Fourth, God is good. Fifth, God is holy. So then the law is holy, and the commandment is holy, righteous, and good. Romans 7, verse 12. Sixth, God is spiritual. We know that the law is spiritual. Verse 14. Seventh, God is eternal. The law of the Lord will last forever. Eighth, God is righteous. All your commands are righteous. Psalm 119, verse 172. Ninth, God is peace. Great peace have those who love your law, and nothing can make them stumble. Verse 165. Children, the people of the world spend billions of dollars a year to hire lawmakers to make the laws of our countries. Men have made more than 36 million laws and add more every year. God made 10 commandments and he has never needed to change them. But the amazing thing is that if every human being actually kept the 10 commandments, we wouldn't have to elect members of Congress to make more laws. And we would be happier if they would find their joys and their peace and their happiness in obeying the eternal laws of God and in those laws to meditate day and night. Then we could delight ourselves in the Lord and say, "Oh, how I love your law. I meditate on it all day long." This is the end of our morning worship. Children, are you currently having a hard time? Are you feeling sad because many things are happening that are not in your expectations? Do you need something that can heal your feelings? If so, then together, let's find the source of that happiness. Children, God's word of advice this morning reminds you that, "But whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on his law day and night." Thus, the source of your happiness is loving the law of God and meditating on it day and night. Children, it turns out that the source of your happiness is something that doesn't have to be bought at a high price. You just need to love God's law and meditate on it day and night. And of course, you will find happiness and peace again. You will again rejoice in God and say, "Oh, how I love your law. I meditate on it all day long." Children, I pray that you will always be happy in your life with God. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.